Hi there, this is Jessamine again of Jessamine Creates. Thank you for coming back on my YouTube channel and for watching this video. Today we are on episode 2 of Mini Sketchbook Tour, and I have here my old 2018 sketchbook, and this is from Talents Art Creation. The paper that I used here is actually a watercolor paper, but I just glue it on paper from the sketchbook itself because it's not really watercolor paper. You will notice that I use a watercolor brush pen, and it's also with layers, so unfortunately it bleed through the paper, so that's why I decided to put some watercolor glue watercolor paper on top of it and just draw on it. And I don't mind it because it's actually for myself, it's not for someone else. And you will notice later on that this sketchbook is really thick. It's because almost half of the sketchbook is glued with watercolor paper. The first part of this sketchbook tour is all about lettering and some illustration. The idea is actually came from when I studied psychology way back in the Philippines, and we have this project from our professor that she will give us quotes, and then we will make our own reflection on the quotes that she gave. So it's actually from the book Be Good to Yourself Therapy, and it's under the psychotherapy subject. And it was really nice because it's I can express my feeling on this particular exercise, but also at the same time I also express my illustration, my skills of drawing, and I really love it. I will show you some samples of the sketch that I made before, but this is actually not my own sketchbook. It was from my classmate. I'm happy that she still have a copy. Shout out to Alma Babas, one of my best friends during my college years, and also to our professor, Ma'am Gwendolyn Leano, for this activity. So this time on the sketchbook, I have this quotes on the right side, and then on the left side, I'm expressing it the way I want it. So if you want to try this one, you don't really need to literally or really visually express it the way you see it on a lettering. It can also be your own interpretation, your own reflection, and you don't have to explain a lot there because it's for yourself. So it's for your recording your own memories. And normally when I do this kind of thing, a reflection and lettering, I normally simplified it. I don't have to explain a lot to tell all the details on this sketch. It's not like when you are making a diary or something like that. It's more about the illustration of symbolics, symbolic interpretation. So it's all about your emotion, putting on a sketchbook or visualizing it instead of explaining something. Minimalizing all the illustration that you made without too much text is also safe. So for example, if I lost this sketchbook and I put a lot of details there, like for example a diary thing, I'm gonna be really fucked up, or I'm really be scared because maybe somebody will read it, or you know, things like that. It was my private sketchbook. Really, I don't really want people to read it. So for me, if I'm just gonna do it like this, I know exactly what I'm doing here, and that's more important. It's for myself and not for somebody else, so I can simplify it the way I want it. And if I lost it, it's okay. Of course it's not okay, but it's still safe, you know. So this kind of sketching is actually nice to mix it with everything, mixed media or anything, like collage or any photograph that you want to glue on your sketchbook, or print some from a magazine or stickers, anything. So actually the drawings that I have here, I already draw this like 5 years ago. It was only, I have it on my drawers. Like, I need to put some drawing here because I miss a lot of pages here that there's no drawing. So I thought, like, instead of making a new drawing, maybe I'm just gonna cut this drawing that I have and just glue it here. And it's just for the purpose of this blog, by the way. But normally when I do this kind of sketching, I always have a connection to the quote itself. This is also nice to just meditation or to just to relax, pastime activity. So here I'm also again just draw something. There is again no connection on this drawing. I just don't know the other day what to do with this, because when I'm flipping all the pages, I thought like when I'm filming, exactly when I was filming, and then I thought like, okay, this is already full, so I'm gonna film it and show it to you guys, all the pages. And then I saw these three pages are still empty, so I thought like, oh no, I need to draw something, and that's why I came up with that. So I hope it also inspired you to start sketching like this style, you know, like reflection and lettering. And this is, by the way, the start of the sketchbook tour. So I hope you like it. Have fun, and I'll see you again at the end. If you, by the way, like this kind of style and like, for example, you want to learn the lettering that I made here, let me know with the comment section below. So maybe in the future, I will give you another YouTube vlog on how to create this kind of beautiful lettering. So we're almost finished with quotes and lettering. So now we're heading to a different way to fill up your sketchbook. And this is more urban sketching and many, many more. And I hope you also like this one. I hope you're also gonna try this one. So urban sketching, if you don't know about urban sketching, is actually about observation. Sketching outside, it's also a best way to fill up your sketchbook, to record your memories. And the idea is actually to sketch things that you see and not what you think you see. Telling you something that you don't have to be perfect while doing this. It's all about the way how you see things. So it's also nice to put it on your sketchbook instead of just making photograph, sketch it. Okay, food sketching, it's also again observation. And when I do food sketching, it's actually the moment when I'm free from work or waiting for someone, and anything on top of my table I sketch. So this is the best also way to fill up your sketchbook, and at the same time you're also doing like a journal, sketch journaling. What I also like of having a sketchbook is to use it as a concept for my commission. So if I have, for example, a commission, portrait commission, and I don't really go straight to canvas and draw or paint there. I first do it on my sketchbook to familiarize the texture, the characteristic of the portrait, of the things, of the subject that I'm making, before I go straight to canvas. And this way, when I do that, it's always easy for me to go straight to a big canvas, because I'm already know all the characteristic of a person that I'm making. This is the example of the portrait commission that I made. If you go straight to my other Instagram account, JV Tutanias, you will find this painting that I made of this pet portrait. Thank you. One thing I also like on sketching is doing a random sketching. It's actually a small elements, small drawings on one full page. It's like a collage. I really love this because it looks so playful, and you don't have to really be perfect with this because you just sketch anything you see around you in one full page. And yeah, that's it. It's not perfect, but it's fun to do. When I have a sketchbook, I don't really keep one style for the full sketchbook. I always combine it with things like this, especially this one. I also use a sketchbook to practice my skills. Like for example, different kind of eyes, body, hands. It's the best way to practice your skills on a sketchbook because you always can return to it. You can look back at it in the future and see the progress. Do you love traveling? Bring some sketchbook while you are on travel. Yeah, okay, we are in a pandemic, so of course we cannot do it now, but just for example, everything is open again, bring some sketchbook with you because it's more fun than just a photograph. We are in lockdown of course, but this is the best way to practice your skills to sketch, and once we are open again to travel around the world, then you can freely express yourself through sketching on your sketchbook. It's fun way to record memories again. This is like travel sketching. And if you already like to do urban sketching, try to find a group. This is my tip. Try to find a group on Facebook, urban sketcher group, city, something like that. Like this one, when I went to Copenhagen to visit my friends. I have a lot of friends there, so I thought like I'm gonna combine the weekend also doing urban sketching. And then so I searched on Facebook, Urban Sketchers Copenhagen, and then I found a group, and they're so friendly that they wanted to sketch with me on that weekend, Saturday, something like that, in Newhound. And I really love it because they are so friendly. We had a drinks and a bar and share our sketch, and it's fun way because after that, when I saw them again in a symposium in Amsterdam, urban sketching symposium in Amsterdam, they're there, so it's nice to say hello to them. And you meet friends, new friends, and it's just perfect way to also to socialize through sketching. So I also love to sketch what is a highlight of the year. For example, this one, the Notre Dame. Did you still remember that 2019 when the Notre Dame was on fire? So I did sketch it on my sketchbook, so I don't forget. And the last page, I forget again. There was empty again, so I thought like I'm just gonna sketch a pen. Yeah, why not? You can sketch anything on your sketchbook. Have fun, and I hope I'll see all the beautiful sketches on your sketchbook. Follow me on Instagram at Jessamine Creates, and tag me if you also made a lot of beautiful sketches on your sketchbook. Also, if you also inspired with this kind of style. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and please click the notification button so you always be notified once I upload a new video for you guys. Thank you again, lovely people, and have a nice creative weekend. Bye.